you told me to go online and find it. I did it online and found it. This project is not on the list, right?
That's correct. It's not. Okay. Right now, you've got State Route 36, of course, from Interstate 81 to the Washington County line. Of course, the remainder just recently completed. You've got State Route 126, of course, Memorial Boulevard from Center Street to Interstate 81. It's over several years, several phases. You've got State Route 93. There's three sections. One is actually in Washington County Fall Branch. The other two is Salt Gardens to Fall Branch. And then there's a lot of bridge projects. There's, I think, a dozen or so bridge projects. And that's basically what's in the group act for Salt County.
Right. I read that there's several bridge projects. And just for one thing, Angie, you probably would need to reword your resolution to ask that this project even be put on the list before it could be added to a priority, because you're asking for it to be improved and its priority is not even on here. And then my other question was, who made this list? I know it was made in the legislature, but why is this project, if you all been talking about it for many years, why is it not on the list? And if it does go to the top of the priority, if we are successful in asking TDOT to do that or the legislature to change this list, because Mr. Belgeri has sort of made it sound to me like this request would have to go through the legislature because the Improve Act list was part of the act, part of the law, and not just some other list, but it does allow TDOT to change it. So anyway, that was a little fuzzy to me. But where does that affect the other things that are here? If this gets moved to the top, how does it affect many things on here? Those of us in the Bristol area might note that one of the things on here is a road from the racetrack over to Interstate 81 and 211W. It's got a hefty price tag of $85 million on here. There's a lot of small bridge projects, but some, like you said, some big ones, like out in the Fall Branch area where it's like a, over $1 million for three quarters of a mile. A lot of things on here. So how would that affect what's going forward on the other projects? And, you know, my question is, why wasn't it included to start with? Because it seems to me like one of the things.
To be honest with you, I'm not really sure where the exactly where that came from. I know that they looked at the area of long-range transportation plans because basically every urban area, and that's Bristol and Kingsport, which includes part of the county, has a long-range transportation plan, and the 36 project has been on there, the Airport Parkway, the North project, is on the plan. And the project, the Bristol project over to from the racetrack over to the interstate is been on there as well. I guess the question is, you know, how are they prioritized? And we're not really sure.
Right, that I've looked. I'm sorry for interrupting, but that's also a question. Because the list that you can find does not give any priority. It just lists the truck and doesn't say which one's most important. Just my request is, as we push for this, would be that somehow we get something from Nashville that tells us. And if they didn't talk to you guys when they made this list, you know, who did they talk to? So that's just some concerns I have. Where does that set us in the future? And what is the priority? Because it's not listed where I can find it.
Yeah, I'll say, and I hope I'm accurate, that they didn't discuss this with county commissions or city boards. The list came from somewhere else.
Thank you, Mr. Bullock. Commissioner Herring. Commissioner Herring.
Yes, I'd like to ask Commissioner Stanley if all those that's voted in the affirmative could be added as a co-sponsor to show the consolidarity of the commission.
Yes,
without objection. Commissioner Ballard.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I just want to clarify that this moving it up on the priority list is not going to change any process in it. The people will still have public hearings. All the process that we go through on roads stays. They were not bypassing anything, correct?
That is absolutely correct.
Thank you.
Any further questions for Mr. Albright before we go back in session? Commissioner Stanley, you're recognized.
Thank you, Chairman. All this is doing is just prioritizing the improvement for Sullivan County. We are asking for Highway 357 to be on the priority list to go in and to do it. Our number one concern should be the safety of these children to and from school, no matter where they're at. This is not going to affect kids in my district a whole lot, except for the ones that live on Hemlock Drive. If we do not do this highway, prioritize it, I feel like that these kids' safety on these little one-and-a-half-lane roads will be put at risk. That should be our number one priority. I don't just represent my district. I represent Sullivan County. And it's my job to make sure that every single child in this county, whether they're coming from Bloomingdale, whether they're coming from Sullivan Gardens, whether they're coming from Indian Springs or Blountville, has a safe way to this new high school. Thank you.
Commissioner Larry Crawford.
Bill, this particular corridor, have you seen the corridor that Ms. Stanley has proposed that we advocate for?
It's on the map.
Yeah. How does that fit in with what you guys have seen in the
pretty
past?
Well. Yeah, we're trying to avoid neighborhood subdivisions, try to use vacant property, and try to look at a route that doesn't have the horizontal vertical curves that are dangerous. You have 9-3 turns and stuff like that. So it fits pretty well. It misses most the homes, the neighborhoods, and geometrically work pretty well.
So this quarter, you feel like you could support that?
Yep.
Okay.
And it's most likely, and Mr. Bill Jerry can back me up on this, it's going to be, design-wise, it would be more of a super two-lane. It would not be what you've got now for Airport Parkway, which is, from the airport out to Interstate 81, which is basically an interstate 200-foot byway. It would be a super two-lane with, good geometry and wide shoulders. It doesn't take up as much real estate to develop someone.
Thank you, Mr. Crawford. Commissioner Stanley.
Thank you, Chairman. I know that a lot of people, to do a cut-through road, to keep from traveling on some of these little roads, are going to go through really nice neighborhoods out there in that area. And I don't think that people in those neighborhoods want their neighborhoods to be used as a cut-through to try to get to this school. I think that this highway right here should be our number one priority on this improvement.
Thank you, Commissioner. Any further words for our guest, Mr. Rothman? If not, we'll go back into session. Bill, thank you for coming. We always